God bless you, and thank you for tuning in to Walking in Your Destiny Christian Talk Show. My name is Shawna Whitehead, and I'm your host, and here with me is my...
I am Tammi McGowan. I am your co-host. God bless you, and thank you for being here this afternoon. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And here with me, we have an outstanding young man. Today's theme is outstanding youth who are making a difference in our surrounding areas. Amen. And we have here with me, he's a junior bishop. He's studying to be a bishop. Oh, Lord, it's a bug, but we outside. It's all good. His name is Mr. Jamar Davis. Give it up for him.
Amen. Amen.
And we are so blessed to have him here. I know you're looking at our scenery. We're doing something different today.
Yes,
we're blessed to be able to do an outside live taping here at New Beginnings Are Possible, located at 3717 West Fond du Lac. And we were blessed to be able to get their facility. Give it up.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yes, yes, amen. Yes. And so we want to encourage our youth, because we always hear about negativity in Wisconsin that's going on, and we never applaud our youth. And we have youth that's going to be on this show that are making a difference in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Amen. 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 So as we move forward, we thank you, Jamar, for being with us this afternoon. But we just ask you to allow God just to touch and reach out to those. All right? Amen. Amen. Amen.
So how is God? I mean, what are you doing in the community? Just let God use you. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm 18 years old. I've been working for the Lord ever since I was a little boy. Mm-hmm. God called me into the ministry. I was real young. Amen. I really didn't understand what God wanted me to do. Mm-hmm. But I followed a path of righteousness.
Amen.
I've been doing community service my whole life. I know and I believe that once you do a volunteer experience, I believe one day you get a blessing.
Amen.
So one day I'm a full-time bishop, and I want God to be the use me here.
Amen.
In the city of Milwaukee.
That's awesome. Amen.
So now, Jamar, so you just graduated, right, from high school?
Yes.
So you'll be going on to college, correct?
Yes.
And where will you be going?
We'll have to go to MATC and Georgia Tech University.
Amen.
Okay. All right. Amen. Amen.
And what would you be majoring?
I'm majoring in broadcasting and education administration.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Amen. Amen. And what church do you attend?
I attend Mark Carmel Missionary Baptist Church on 17 West Monica Avenue.
Amen.
Amen. Well, who's your bishop? We got to give him a shout out now.
Bishop Dr. Hugh Davis Jr.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So what things do you do in your surrounding areas that you can help other young people today?
I do a lot of community activities.
Like what?
Top Teens of America, while I was the president over there at the chapter. And what basically we do is all our teens across America, we come together and be leaders of tomorrow.
Okay.
Because we realize there's not a lot of leaders in the city of Milwaukee, but we strive to be leaders.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And how do you become a leader?
Well, nobody really born a leader. You have to practice to be a leader. Like Dr. King, he practiced. He wasn't born a leader. Look at Barack Obama, the president of the United States of America. He's a leader. And in order to be a good leader, you have to learn how to follow. A good follower.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And you know, Jamar, as you've gone through Top Teens, and as you learn how to take on leadership skills, and as they teach you, do you see that in your everyday life and when you're in school and through your different community work, that you're using those same skills to pour out onto others? Do you find that you're doing that as you walk the walk that God has given you?
Oh, yes. And I realize once I do that, I'm going to lose a lot of friends along the way.
Mm-hmm. But that's okay.
Oh, yes.
Okay. You know, one thing about serving God, it's probably not the most popular thing in our society, but one thing about God is that his path is narrow, and you staying on it, he always keeps you.
Oh, that's right.
So that one thing should comfort you, especially in the difficult areas as we walk that path, okay? Amen.
And I think what you're doing is very, very positive. But, you know, we do have a question for you. You're not going to get off scot-free. Okay, I have a question. How would you help other young people strive for excellence? And how would you point them to Jesus Christ?
Good question.
Mm-hmm. That's why I asked.
Well, the first question I want to answer is that, whatever is seen to be impossible is possible. And like I said before, nobody is born a leader. You have to make a way up there to be a leader. But you have to realize in that process that you're going to lose a lot of true friends you thought was your friends that really wasn't your friends at all. And to bring somebody to Christ, first you have to accept them, the Lord Jesus Christ, as your Savior.
Amen.
You have to confess. It's not a whole process, but you have to believe in your heart that God is real, because faith is the size of a mustard seed. So we have to have faith that God is who he is.
Amen. Amen. Y'all, we need to clap for that. Amen. Amen. A young, positive African-American brother that's living for God. I'm just so blessed to have you as my friend.
Thank you.
To be on this show. Amen.
And Jamar, I just want to say that I truly thank God, especially for the importance of you following through on your education.
Yes.
Education is the most most important weapon we can use to change the world. So as you're being taught to be that leader, your education is imperative. So as you go forth, I ask that as you go to your classes, as you continue to do what you're doing, please encourage those in, through, and around their education.
That's right.
Everyone has to be educated.
That's right.
Amen.
And you know what? Young people here are going to look at you. They're going to look at this this taping, and you're going to be surprised who you're going to be a role model for people that don't even know you. So continue to let God use you.
Amen.
Continue to walk in that light, because that's what it's about. And I'm just so blessed to be able to do this show, because it's a blessing and honor to see young people that are making a difference in their community. And it's not nothing negative, but it's some positive things going on. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We just praise God and we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, sharing it with Jamar.
Amen.
And we just look forward to seeing you in the future. Amen. For you being that mighty man to come in and move some things and shake some things up in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. Just as we were looking at the Olympics, and we have to give God all the glory for the African American gold medalist, Gabby. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. We gotta give. I was looking at a quote, and she said, "I give all the glory to God," and I had to say, "Amen."
Amen.
And then she went on to say, "It's a win-win situation, because giving all the glory to Him, all the blessings fall down on me." So you know, that's a quote that we can truly take and learn from our young people, that God is doing a mighty thing.
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen. So we just praise and thank God for you being here. Amen.
Amen. And so for those who do not know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, if you are a young person and you want to know Jesus and have this illuminating light, as my young friend here, Minister Jamar Davis, you can know him today.
Amen.
If you would close your eyes with me and bow your head with a sincere heart and repeat after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I acknowledge that I'm a sinner. I believe that you died on the cross for our sins.
Amen.
And I need you to be in my life. I need you to be the ruler and the head of my life.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
And in Jesus' name I pray. I thank you for coming into my heart.
Amen.
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 And if you said this and you believe this, now you too are a born again Christian.
Amen.
Now let's clap it.
Amen.
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 And we just want to thank you for all of those that accepted Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. We just ask that you would find a Bible teaching church that teaches the truth of the Word of God.
Yes, hallelujah.
Because one thing about it, there are a lot of churches out here, but we need you to get the real, that infallible Word, that Word which is transformative. Because this walk that we walk, truly, we don't walk it alone. We walk it with God ahead of
us.
Right.
Amen. And that He would dwell within us.
Amen.
So we ask that you would give us a call on our prayer line at 1-888-316-0762. Or you can send us a letter at P.O. Box 16639, Milwaukee, Wisconsin 53216. Thank you. Thank you for joining the family.
And you know what? Before we end, you can tune in every day every Friday at 4 p.m. at ShawnaWhitehead.com, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And also, we have a special guest that's coming up to praise dance for
us.
Her name is Sondaya Whitehead, who is my best friend, my daughter, and I just thank God for her. So she's gonna take us on out in the show, and she's also another outstanding youth who is making a difference in her surroundings.
Amen.
Amen. God bless. Amen.
This is my little girl, Sondaya Whitehead, and Tammy's friend, right, Tammy?
Yeah, she is truly my friend. God bless. I just thank God for you, but you know that. No.
And she's going to do a special dance for us and a praise dance. So just let God use you, okay? Don't be nervous. Can I get a kissy?
Amen.
Amen.
Not an hour, another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you.
I need you now, Lord.
have a blessed, come on over here, Tammi. Y'all have a blessed and prosperous week. God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen.